Before 1994, addresses were divided into a network ID portion and a host ID portion. So if we take our 32 bits, suppose the first bit is a 0, note that that's half of all IPv4 address space. Anything that starts with a 0 is going to be known as a class A address, and the next 7 bits will represent the network ID, or the network that owns this portion of address space. The remaining portion of the address space is dedicated for hosts on that network. In this case, any class A network can support up to 2 to the 24th hosts. Addresses that started with 10 were designated as class B networks, where the first 16 bits signified the network ID, and the remaining 16 bits signified the host ID for that network. Note here that each class B address range represents about 1/65,000th of all internet address space. So discounting the first two bits, which indicate that this is a class B network, we have about 2 to the 14th unique class Bs, each of which can have 2 to the 16th, or 65,000 hosts on each network. Class Cs use the first 24 bits for the net ID, and the remaining 8 for a host ID. So each class C network essentially can only have 255 hosts on it. This plot shows the BGP routing table size as a function of the year, starting in 1989 and going up to 1994. You can see that at this time, the internet routing table is quite small. It started at less than 5,000 prefixes. By comparison, now we have about 500,000 IP prefixes in the internet routing table. But we can see in this period that internet routing table growth began to accelerate. In particular, the growth rates were exceeding the advances in hardware and software capabilities, and in particular, we began to run out of the Class C address allocation. There were far more networks that needed just a handful of IP addresses, such as a Class C address space could provide, and yet, because only a certain range of the IP address space could be used for Class C addresses, we began to run out fairly quickly. So there began to be a need for more flexible allocation. The solution to this problem was something called classless interdomain routing, or CIDR, something that we'll cover in the next lesson.